That's it? That's your introduction?
Yeah, that's my introduction is, hi.
Hi.
This is Assassin's Creed Rogue, played by a fat man and an American. Enjoy!
So we're Abbott and Costello.
I've never actually made a video like this before. I've just seen people make videos like this before.
Yes, probably.
Oh, going the wrong way.
Alright, so...
Okay, this is... man, this is not fun to play. Wow! She just backhanded a dude. That's a rather bourgeois thing to do.
Oh, God. Yeah, we were just doing this thing. We were just doing this thing when
He's
we first.
Man.
Let me finish, goddammit. We were doing this thing when we first started the video that whenever he saw someone with a lot of money, he would kill them claiming that they are bourgeoisie.
He says a lot of money. It really does not require a lot of money.
So
it's like the random peasants smoking cigars I count among the bourgeoisie.
You could have a penny in your pocket and you would be considered bourgeoisie. In
yeah,
eyes.
No, I cut down a dude because I robbed him and he had 11 whole pounds.
So in other words...
Oh, they are still there!
So you are not doing Shane McCormack any justice.
No, I am not being a pleasant person.
And Shane's maybe one of the nicer assassins.
Except he's not that Shay is the guy I'm playing, right?
Yes.
Yeah, then Shay is not technically an assassin, man.
He's
you own a hoe. That seems somewhat bourgeoisie.
You a pip.
Okay, now I'm gonna... Oh, no, somebody saw
French pip. Hey, you know the guy from Inside the Actors Studio?
Nope.
You don't know the guy?
Nope, no idea what you're talking about.
It's a TV show where this dude interviews, like, celebrities. He's a guy with glasses. Big guy. Well, apparently before he started doing his show, he used to be a pimp down in France.
Wow!
Yeah. He started out being a pimp, but then he went to America and started his own TV show.
Well, I mean, Jamie Geary is the Australian guy. He hosted a bunch of TV shows. I can't remember. There was one that, I think it was called Hot Property. It was like The Block.
Hmm.
And he was like the 90s, he was like the Australian 90s game show host.
Okay.
And before he was a game show host, he was a male stripper.
Really?
Yeah.
Holy shit. So he's straight
up. Well, and so was Channing Tatum.
Yeah, well.
It's funny, I've actually.
Really? But like, it's not Magic Mike. He was actually a male stripper before he became an actor.
Yeah.
Wow.
Channing Tatum was.
Wow.
It's funny, he was apparently, and I've heard, I'm not sure of the truth of this. But I heard that he was with an interview and they showed a video of him back in the days that he actually was stripping. And the guy who was interviewing him was like, so do you get like embarrassed by this at all? And he was like, look at this. Would you be embarrassed if that was you?
That, to be fair, like, after
yeah, it's
you
like,
done...
you look at Channing Tatum and you're like, that's not someone to be embarrassed of.
Yeah, if I was Channing Tatum, I would have
You would
no
never
shame.
Have your clothes on.
Now, Jupiter Ascending, that would be something to be embarrassed of, because...
Oh, mayhap, yes. Then again, Mila Kunis, she was there, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
Where is the flipping tavern?
Yeah.
I lost track of it.
Alright, and if you see my hands, by the way, I'm putting my finger on the touchpad in case it's about to go to sleep. Because then it just lags the video, because we're recording this on my laptop, and there's all sorts of like technical hoo-has that will either mess it up, or it will...
Technical hoo-has. The screen started to go to sleep, that's not a technical hoo-ha.
Technical hoo-has.
Don't remind me of Austin Powers, that's not something I need in my life again.
I was going with Al Pacino.
Really?
Technical hoo-has!
Really? You weren't going for the fembots with the machine gun nipples.
How did I miss those,
how did I miss those, baby? Is this the tavern I see?
Does it have like a little simp? Yeah. No, those are guards.
Well, I didn't stab them, so...
No, they're fine. They're
I may
fine.
Have gone to stab them, but I failed.
Okay.
Hide
in the crops, they'll never notice you.
No, they didn't know I was trying to stab them. That hurt.
All you have to do to scare off the Templars is that you have to cut off your head, get a flaming pumpkin head, and pretend to be the Headless Horseman.
Cut off your own head. Okay, I'm seeing the first issue with this plan.
No, it would be perfect. Like, oh, you know how chickens, they run round around the farmyard after they have their heads cut off?
Yes, they're not actually technically alive anymore. You understand that, yes?
Well, you know. No, they still got their nerves and everything. You just follow your nerves and the spirit of the pumpkin will do the rest.
Your head is no longer your nerves.
The pumpkin will be
your head.
Your head
is no longer attached.
The pumpkin will be your head. All you have to do is to try and find a magical pumpkin that is still somehow essence of magical and is alive. And
it's dark enough that I can't actually see shit.
Oh, shit.
I'm just taking swings. Glowing. Probably who? Okay, shit's going upwards.
You're gonna have to run.
Shit has gone fan inclined.
Jump in the water!
Why, there's like eight dudes all waiting to take a shot at me.
Hide in the bushes.
Yeah, oh, come on.
Oh god.
What, there's a bush in the way so I can't exit the river?
Apparently, yes.
Well then.
Yes, stay under the bridge. You will forever be a troll.
Yes.
Yeah, remember when, back when Troll used to actually be a mythical creature and not someone who's actually be shitty on the
internet.
Whoa,
that got dark quickly.
Yeah, we're playing on my, because we're playing on the PC, the software that I'm recording on is on a very, very tiny screen, and we can't use full screen on it.
It's a MacBook, and it's like a quarter of the screen.
Yeah, I haven't figured out how to get it onto an actual monitor like a civilized human being.
It is playable. That's about all I'm willing to say.
You can use your controller and interact with the environment around you.
It's like, I can move and I can recognize what is my character and what isn't my character.
Do it again.
But that's about all the quality that I've got.
That's more to do with the perspective and less to do with the actual graphics. Like, thank God for those.
I want to get drunk.
I think you missed it, actually. I think you ran right past it.
Why didn't you say anything?
I did, but
you were
running away.
Shit.
I was running. You were running away, is what you were doing. You Australian shit.
Yeah.
You Crocodile Dundee wannabe.
You Crocodile Dundee. Happy Hogan.
Have you ever seen Crocodile
Steve
Dundee?
Steve Irwin, motherfucker.
Steve Irwin, motherfucker.
Steve Irwin was the greatest.
Yeah. Crikey.
You are so bad at that.
Crikey. I'm Australian now.
Yeah, no, you're an American going, crikey, stone me crows, eh? And everybody in Australia is like, you try. Don't try again.
What are you talking about?
It's like, hey, what are you talking about? This is an Australian accent, eh?
God. How would you love to do that in real life? Just, like, be able to fall back first into a haystack?
I'd rather not. I've been in haystacks and then...
I've tried...
Very itchy.
I've tried...
Don't ask.
I've tried them before. Okay, farm. Farm.
Yes,
farm back.
Yes. Many farm.
I did that before when I was, like, raking leaves one time. Oh, that actually means an assassin's on you.
Oh, hey, buddy.
Oh, you see that,
No. Okay, stab one dude.
Never
He's
mind.
Still alive.
I'll tell you later. Just run. Run.
No, you can talk.
Okay. You see that,
They're not gonna kill me.
You know when the red,
oh,
like,
I forgot.
Remember when the red blurry stuff was around your screen? That stuff? That means that there's, like, a hidden assassin somewhere. So you have to,
those are shitheads, I know them.
Yeah.
I know them.
So you gotta use your eagle eye vision and then try to scope them out.
Yeah, no, I prefer to just leg it.
Yeah.
Oh my god, I'm back here! You bastard.
You bastard.
You a filthy bastard.
Brooklyn Rage. See, when we're not talking about... When we're not talking about shit with each other, we're quoting other people that are funnier than us.
Oh, yeah, obviously.
It's the truth.
That's like my only comedy, is referring to myself, which is just hilarious, because I'm an asshole.
It's the code of every comedian, to either talk shit about yourself, or talk shit about other people, or just be a... Or just quote other people that are much funnier than you.
Yep.
It's how, God, who am I thinking of?
Describe them?
I would say someone like Doug Walker, the Nostalgia Critic.
I've never watched much of Doug, the Nostalgia Critic.
Who's that? I will admit that I have been watching his stuff for like 6 years now, so you can say I'm one of the diehard fans, but even I admit some of his stuff is like more on the okay side at times.
I've watched a couple of videos of his, but I couldn't tell you anything that I've seen.
Yeah, fair enough. What's another?
Not like Zero Punctuation.
Yeah, Zero Punctuation.
And I love Zero Punctuation.
Yeah, I will admit, Zero Punctuation is very sharp.
And see, I like Zero Punctuation because he's exactly not what you're talking about.
Mm. Like, he doesn't... So
like,
he'll
reference other stuff, but his humor doesn't lie in referencing other stuff.
But I think the only thing that I have about zero punctuation is that sometimes it can be a little bit too fast-paced. Like,
okay, nuts to this.
Like, call me a bit of a dumbass, but sometimes it just makes it a little bit hard to keep track of what he's talking about.
That is the Harbor Master.
I think that's it right there.
Viewpoint where?
Right there. Right. There we go.
Tavern.
That's
okay.
It. There we go. So now we know it's a jug.
Is it literally this building?
No. It's not this building.
It is literally this building. That I must have run past.
Yes.
Several times. I am the greatest, ladies and gentlemen.
You are a master. Like,
I'm
Total Biscuit ain't got nothing
just,
on you.
Just brilliant.
A Rage Quit ain't got nothing on you. Alright, so...
Yeah, no, cause...
No,
do
don't...
I want...
Sure, go ahead.
Dramatic pirate checkers.
Yeah, here we are. We're going to play Assassin's Creed Rogue. We're not going to play for any of the action or shit. We're just going to just do it just to play... Just watch Simon here play checkers.
Oh, obviously. For the smallest possible bet, because I am a puss. Oh, okay. This is going to be interesting.
I
can barely see
You guys can't see this right now, but this will probably look better on the actual video, but right now it is dark as shit. You cannot see. Is that a little bit better?
It's a little bit better.
Yeah, because right now this is as dark as shit, and he cannot see the black to save his life. And the beige chips, they look like they're brown, and they're just like... It looks like a Tim Burton video or something like that. Like a Tim Burton movie. There's so much shadow and shit over everything.
This ought to be interesting.
Mm. You're doing pretty good so far.
I'm literally like one move in. Now.
Well, you're getting checked. Well, you're getting points. And now I...
Gotcha, bitch.
See, I have no idea how that... No, I can see that actually, because it's like a line, isn't it?
It's if you directly approach one, then you get it, and all the ones directly behind it. And if you move away directly away from one, you get it, and all of it.
So it's the only game where retreating actually helps you win the game.
Well, I mean, unless you're French, yeah.
It's the perfect game for the Frenchman.
Exactly.
Well, unless you're...
You say?
Okay, so what's your opinion on Napoleon? I don't know.
Napoleon is the... Move your hand, you... Napoleon is the last badass Frenchman.
Yeah.
Which is hilarious, because he wasn't French.
Wasn't he?
No, he was Corsican.
Wow. Oh, okay. And even though, like, he made a lot of mistakes, like, at least he had the balls to at least go out there.
See, to me, it's just more that... He was so very...
Aggressive?
No, it's just like, they imprisoned him, and then he basically swam his way to freedom.
Wow.
So they imprisoned him again. So he swam his way back to freedom again.
So, yeah, he's just like...
The motherfucker just didn't stop.
He may have been insane. So I was like, unpopular opinion, Napoleon was a badass.
I don't think that's actually that unpopular an opinion.
Next, we'll be saying that Hitler was very underrated.
Whoa. Napoleon didn't start a genocide.
Well, he was going to when he got to Russia. If he did get into Russia anyway.
I'm not so sure about that. But, I mean, that's... I feel like that's more of a...
Like a territorial thing?
More of a subjective thing. Because, I mean, like...
There's a lot of
Hitler
what-ifs.
Was absolutely going to kill...
Yeah.
Like, he was absolutely all about that genocide.
He's all about that genocide.
Like, that is absolutely what Hitler was... Oh, no, I know what he's gonna do. That was a mistake. Like, Hitler was absolutely going to genocide. That was what he was there to do. Oh, good God.
Oh, wow. You just took out a...
Aha.
Wow, that's a lot of roads he took down, and you don't have that much compared to him. Oh, nice.
Yeah. This is actually a really interesting game, and I'd like to actually get this, like, on a board.
Yeah, that would be pretty cool. Looks like... I think I saw, like, a movie...
No!
Oh, shit.
You bastard.
You know, I think I saw a movie about the Congo... I think it was either Apocalypse Now or something, where someone was playing this game. And it was, and it looked pretty complicated, but it looked cool. Actually, you know what this looks like? Looks like a Jumanji.
Oh, no. Looks no, like... I don't want to do that.
Come on, you know you must.
No, because if I do, I'll take that black piece, and then he'll move his other black piece and take it.
You know, you could have gone to the...
No, I couldn't. As long as you have, as long as you have a move that can take others.
Mm. Actually, you know what this game reminds me of? It reminds me of, Jumanji.
Really?
Mm. It's got that kind of layout.
Oh, good God.
Wow.
I'm just a wee bit fucked.
Wow. You may be losing this bet, sir.
Not necessarily.
You think you got something?
Maybe.
The music kind of reminds me of, Over the Garden Hill. Have you watched that, by the way?
Nope.
I gave you the link, man. You still haven't, yeah, Over the Garden Hill is a pretty good show, by the way. It's about these, if you haven't seen it, it's about these, kids who are stuck in the woods, these magical woods, and they're trying to find their way back.
Oh yeah, you did tell me about that.
Yeah, it's kind of Grimm's fairy tale-ish, or Disney's Sleeping Hollow mixed with, like, Gravity Falls kind of humor. And it's like,
crap.
Oh, shit, nah.
Yeah, no, there was no way I was gonna get out of it.
Yeah.
I was gonna lose it.
But yeah, it's a really interesting show, and I like the animation. It's kind of dark and moody, but also very colorful as well. And the kids actually...
So like a kiddie sort of, like, happy-go-fun sort of aesthetic, but with a, like, more dark undertone.
Yeah, very much so. Okay. And there's actually a villain called the Beast, who is, like, all in shadow, and he's just got these horns and, like, glowing white eyes. He's a really creepy villain.
Have you ever seen Black Lagoon in the anime?
I've heard of it, but I haven't actually seen it.
It's got a similar sort of thing where it's, like, it's quite a colourful aesthetic, like, you know...
Are you gonna play again?
Yes, I am.
We're counting down, we came here to get crew!
I'll do that after this game, I don't have a problem, fuck you!
You're like one of those people who's just playing solitaire, who's just playing poker non-stop. You're like fucking Carlton when he went to Vegas in that episode of Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. You see, I'm just referencing shit. I don't have any good material, I'm just referencing other people. And hopefully that you guys will find me funny. Please tell me you find me funny! Please! Please!
We all know you don't. Don't lie to him.
Don't get my esteem up.
I shouldn't say these sorts of things, I'm in your house.
Yeah, who's gonna be getting some cake later?
That's true. What kind of cake is it?
It's strawberry cake with it's strawberry icing with some, vanilla and chocolate swirl in the middle.
Fuck me.
And then we've got some brownie, which is chocolate brownie with some white icing. Oh god, I'm getting his taste buds up. But to be fair,
I'm getting it chubby.
And to be fair, I'm gonna have just as much as he is if I do get some. I'm not gonna lie. Yeah, my mom stockpiled on a lot of stuff, and yes, I am living with my parents.
Yeah.
I am not scared to throw it out onto the internet.
Yes, you are.
Yes, you're right. That's why I said it on camera.
Well, yeah.
I'm just so paranoid about that shit. And by the way, for those of you who are, like, fans of the Media Desk show, you might be interested to know that, yeah, all 27 of you.
27?
Tried.
I mean, you got 7,000 hits on that first one.
Yes,
which was insane.
Yeah, that's...
And then your second one now has, like, 27 hits.
I kind of, like, dropped... You may say I dropped the ball on that last one.
Yeah. It's like, for those of you who are watching Media Dusk's YouTube channel, I am so, so sorry.
Well, to be fair, don't be so sorry, because you're going to be in it.
Oh god, yes I am.
Yeah, he's going to
press me like this.
Yeah, he is going to be one of the cast members in the show. But it's not going to be in like the typical sense of like, we're just going to be sitting here playing this shit. Well, no, I shouldn't say shit, I like this game. I do like this game.
Oh, I fucked up. I thought there was a connection later.
No, it's you actually playing a board game in a game, which is like... This is like some shit that you would see in like one of those like 21st century satires where you don't see people actually interacting with the world, you see them like playing a game within a game, or something like that. Kind of like how in like Grand Theft Auto, you see James DeSanta playing that Call of Duty game while you're playing the game, and you're just watching him playing the game.
I hate that character.
Oh, he is such a shithead. He is like, but I do love his like tattoo that he has, his name just entitled. just tattooed on his neck.
Yeah, it's quite an accurate tattoo.
Yeah, but you've got to have some serious balls to have, like, entitled tattooed on your neck and have no shame in that. Yeah, you're a little bit close to that one, mate.
Should have been able to... That didn't make any sense.
Should have been able to do that. Well, to be fair, we are sort of, like, learning the rules as we go. We don't actually have... We haven't actually read the rules. We're just sort of, like, playing as we go, so...
Mm.
There might have been, like, some loophole that we may have missed. Because we don't really like to read through a big load of rules. Next you'll be telling us that we want to read the lore of the Assassin's Creed universe.
I know, right?
Get your head out of the way. Yeah, sorry for not speaking, by the way. This is just... I'm actually interested in what he's going to do.
Yeah, no, this is like actually like almost nerve-wracking.
I love him just like...
The only safe move I have is the pussiest move possible.
He's like... I love that dude, he's like, make your move, yeah. Buddy. What, you're not going to move at all?
Oh, he got... No, he didn't. He didn't.
Oh, shit.
Well, if he does...
I think he is.
That's what... I tried to do that before and it wouldn't let me.
I don't know why. Well, maybe he's just better
that's
than...
That's so dumb.
Maybe he's just better than you.
I bet you shut your mouth.
Well, yeah, not that better than you then, since you're good. I don't know about you, but I really like the Irish pub song that I feel this game. Like when you go to the tavern.
Being part Irish, yeah, I totally get it.
Mm. And actually, we have a friend of ours. She is very much into Irish culture.
She loves Irish culture, which is weird because she's Korean.
Irish Koreans, they're so rare.
Yeah,
to come
no,
by
they exist,
days.
Right?
They're so rare to come by these days. It's from the great Korea to Irish immigration, sort of like a reversal of the whole Australia to Irish. From the whole island to Australia, immigrations of prisoners. Oh god. You may have to. Okay, if we're gonna get somewhere, you may have to either like forfeit or we're going.
I think I can move that!
Yeah.
You can't move the other one back and you can't move anything towards
it? I guess so. Can you move up and then, or maybe move there and then maybe get the ones above that? No.
Yeah. No, because you've got to move directly towards it. If you move anything other than that piece, but that's alright, which just means I can take this.
See, we're learning so much about this game today.
And he can't directly take me.
Ah, okay, that's good. Interesting. There we go. See, it's when you're put into a corner.
But it means that this piece is also in a kind of a shitty place now.
Mm-hmm. See, it's amazing how the strategy game has become much more engaging than you... We'll get to more, like, hacking and slashing soon, but, now we're just gonna have to, do a whole bunch of this. We're just gonna be doing this one way, because I really want to see how far I can go.
I've never gotten so intensely into a, like...
Unless it's, like, Cards Against Humanity, you haven't gotten into, like, a board game this intensely, or...
I don't really get intensely into that. That's something that you can't really get, like, intensely into, because the second you're intensely into it...
I don't know about you, but
you immediately lose.
Yeah, because Cards Against Humanity is like, it's like,
make your move, you bastard!
It's like, whose line is it anyway? The points don't matter.
Exactly.
Hmm. That's right, the points are just like this game. It just doesn't matter in the grand scheme.
Just like your
life. Well, this game within a game, anyway.
Go on, make your move, you bastard.
Make your last pathetic move, Simon.
Yeah, person that exists.
Just focus on Simon and the pretty board game, will you, people?
Nobody focus on me. There's nothing pretty about me.
Don't lie to yourself. You know you're gorgeous.
Don't touch me.
Come here, you.
Oh, God. You're sorry. This is video evidence. I was attacked. I feel unsafe.
Oh, Sam.
Oh, God. I can carry you, Mr. Frodo.
We saw this play. He actually saw this play.
Yeah.
He saw this
I saw this play. He was in a play that was on like at the same time.
Mm-hmm. And there was a scene that was there was this bit in where these two frat boys were quoting Samwise Gamgee.
They basically had the ultimate bro handshake, and it ended with them quoting Lord of the Rings, and then the Sam character throwing him onto his back. And like running around the room a couple of times.
I'm all saying, but
while dramatic music plays.
We gotta have a handshake like that sometime.
No, we don't.
You could lift me.
I definitely could, but.
But you don't want to.
Yeah, that's not something I want to do every time I see you.
Well, you know.
Oh, no.
Oh, shit. Wow, I did not see that coming.
Yeah, as we... come over, maybe bring a headset. I can Bluetooth it, you can put something in the phone. Do you have an optical? Optical audio.
No. It's too old-fashioned. Well, I don't know what you mean by optical audio. What is that?
It's a port.
Is it like a new thing?
No. No.
Yeah, see, I don't know shit. See, I don't know shit. Like, I have a lot of computers, but if you ask me to, like, point all the little key things about it, I built a computer. And yet I still can't name, like, half the shit that I put in there. Like, if you ask me where the, like, what the... I'm that much of a...
What is the hard drive?
What is the motherboard?
I've never built a laptop. I know that I could, like, I've looked into it and I understand all of it, but... Mm.
Yeah, see, I'm the opposite. I built one, I don't understand shit about how it works. I just sort of, like, I just got, like, a friend of mine, or, like, a family friend of mine, who's really good at building computers. He does it for a living. And he managed to, like, guide me over Skype on how to build it.
Okay.
Pretty nice guy, though. Pretty nice guy. But, yeah, that's about what I've done there. I'm just like, I don't need to touch you anymore. I don't need to add any more, like, water coolers or something, anything like that, just to, like, up the fan temperature, the fan spinach and stuff like that. I think I'm just cool with it right now. No pun intended. No pun intended.
I don't want to get backed into this corner.
I think you're on a much of a choice. Because we gotta get going, man. We're spending so much time. We spent, like, 30 minutes on this one little board game. Are you serious? God damn. I don't...
No, see, I can't move him anywhere. Because he'll get taken by him no matter where he moves. He can move basically here.
Well, I think in a situation like this, it's sort of like...
They're trying to trap him.
Well, it's like better safe than sorry, man.
No, you know, it's great. I'm pretty sure that I can trap the computer. Into a stalemate.
Really?
And then I'll move the same thing. Ooh. And then I'll move the same thing. And then I'll ask for a stalemate.
Oh, clever!
If both of you make this... I noticed that. That's what happened the last time I played. If you make the same move, if you both make the same move twice in a row, then you'll ask for a stalemate.
Okay, I think like 30 minutes is good for like a stopping point.
Yeah, sure, okay.
Yeah, we'll
get cake.
Yes, we can get cake.
Okay.
And yeah, we'll just stop right now, but we'll come back. We'll come back and play some more Assassin's Creed Rogue, and there will be more than just playing a board game within a video game.
Yeah, I'll actually go and kill some civilians.
No, kill civilians. Kill Frenchmen.
I'm gonna
kill some Frenchmen.
They're all Frenchmen.
We'll kill the bad Frenchmen.
I'm gonna kill Frenchmen.